The ASEAN Online Sale Day of 2023 this month brings together small to medium enterprises from the region in a bid to promote cross-border commerce.
The Department of Trade and Industry's Ruth Castello joins us on the Business Roadshow to talk about this. Thanks a lot for agreeing to be on the show, Undersecretary Castello. Good afternoon.
Oh, yes. Hi, good afternoon to both of you. It's an honor and a pleasure also to promote the ASEAN Online Sales Day in your program.
All right. Talk to us about that ASEAN Online Sale Day happening this month. What can we look forward to from the event?
Oh, yes. The event starts today, beginning August 8, and it ends on August 22. It has been extended for a longer period so that we can give more promotional materials and we can attract more businesses, MSMEs in particular, to join the sale. As a matter of fact, we have extended also accepting MSMEs who wish to join up to this Friday, up to August 11, despite the fact that we have already started the AOSD today.
Yusa, can you tell us about the two tiers of the AOSD? Specifically the tier one for domestic transactions and then tier two for cross-border transactions. How will e-commerce businesses and platforms participate in each tier?
Oh, yes, of course. The tier one and the tier two that we're talking about is the one on consumer protection. In the website of the ECCP or in the ASEAN Online Sales Day website or in other websites connected to this business, there is a link on dispute resolution. So you click it if you have any complaint from your purchase involving other e-commerce businesses that are there. You click it and you will find there's ACCP mechanism for consumer complaints or dispute resolution. And then there is also the ASEAN Sale Day dispute resolution process. Complaints may be filed with the ECCP even if the transaction did not occur during the online sales day. And the other one, tier two, the one prepared by the ASEAN Secretariat, will accept complaints only for those that were purchased or only transactions that were made during the duration of the online sales day, which is on August 8 to August 23.
Yusa Castello, I'd like to know, I'd like to gauge the impact of such an activity to Filipino sellers. In fact, how many participants are we expecting from the Philippines?
That is one thing that we are really focusing on right now to promote. That's why we also have longer days here so that we can fully promote the online sales day. So far, we have already 91 MSMEs from the Philippines who will join the online sales day. And then there is it's an August 8 up to August 22. The duration of the period is from August 8 to August 22. And then in the last 4 days, actually, there is a, there is a physical sale that will also be happening in Semarang in Indonesia.
Okay.
So MSMEs or buyers who would wish to go to Indonesia so that they can see and touch and feel whatever they're going to buy. It's a 4-day thing from August 19 to August 22. These are the last 4 days of the ASEAN Online Sales Day.
On the side of the Philippines, USEC, what preparations and efforts have been made for the AOSD?
Oh, yes. Of course, with the aligning with the objectives of the ASEAN Online Sale Day, the DTI has already prepared, sent out invitations to our MSEs so that they will be attracted or they will be interested in joining. We have also promotional activities both on TV and on radio, and we also make the most use of the social media so that can attract more sellers and more participants, more shoppers who will attend the online sales day.
Okay, Yusa Castello, let's talk about business to business now. What opportunities are you seeing from this kind of event to promote business to business among ASEAN member countries participating?
Yes, the ASEAN member states are actually very active in this activity, and we can now connect with other countries. Businesses from other countries may be brought by businesses here to the Philippines, and so on and so forth. There will be an exchange of products and services that will happen during the online sale day, so that they can connect and create a bigger network. For them, especially for our local MSMEs, to connect and to go regional, because we have 10 countries in the ASEAN, they will have more people to connect with. They can create a bigger network and maybe collaborate in their business, maybe materials from the Philippines, but the labor to produce a product may be made. Complete interaction, that is what we want, interaction and collaboration also between businesses.
Lastly, Yusek, how do you envision the future of AOSD, and what are your expectations for its continued role in facilitating cross-border e-commerce?
Oh, yes. Well, just to give you a little background, this started in 2020 when almost the whole world was in lockdown, and the ASEAN saw that we should be able to make use and assist the MSMEs whose businesses were affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. So we thought of this in the ASEAN to conduct an online sales day between and among the ASEAN countries that are that needed, of course, assistance with each other per country, inter-country, for their products and services. And then the ACCP created this online sale day. They came up with this so that we can invite MSMEs and the consumers who were willing and ready to spend at that time to buy whatever they need, whether it's for personal use or for a business use. So from then on, it has continued from from 2020 to 2021. We are now on our fourth year, and we would still wish to have to expand this more. Who knows, in the future, maybe next year, we can make it a month-long event so that we can attract more buyers and more sellers in the ASEAN online sales day. Other countries are also, I understand, welcome to join this, but of course they will have to submit their applications either to the ACCP or to the ASEAN secretariats.
DTI Undersecretary Ruth Castelo-Yusek, thank you so much for joining us.
Have a good day.
Of course, thank you for inviting.